Hello. 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 I just wanted to do a quick video to show you how silent the Remo silent stroke drum heads by Remo actually are. I suppose it's difficult for you to gauge unless there's a real drum kit next to it, but it gives you a clue, some sort of insight into it. It's just that I know a few people have purchased drum kits and then they play them in their garage and then it's too loud. Funnily enough, we're all familiar with that situation. Of the neighbour coming round and trying to say, can you turn it down as diplomatically as possible? Most neighbours are like that. Some don't even bother venturing round, but that's fair enough. And some people will just get very cross, but everyone's different, aren't they? These acoustic mesh head things are brilliant. So you take your old drum heads off, including the bass drum, and then you replace them with these, as I say, Remo Silent Stroke drum heads, which are mesh head, yeah? So I think they're more fun than playing either rubber dampening pads or a rubber acoustic practice kit, because they feel, mesh to my mind, feels a bit more real. The other benefit of these mesh heads compared to rubber pads, as in compared to a rubber pad practice kit, is that you've got the pitch coming through as well. So they feel quite real, they sound quite real. If you were to put dampening pads over an acoustic kit, yes, you would retain some of the pitch, but not as much as you do with these. And secondly, these things bounce and feel better, or bounce more realistically than dampening pads on an acoustic kit, I think, anyway. I think they reduce the volume of a real acoustic kit, or an acoustic kit rather, by probably about half. Don't quote me on that, I'm not exactly entirely sure. But they feel fairly real to play, quite comfortable, quite nice to the touch, sound good, they keep the pitch and tone to an extent, and you cut the volume down for around by about half or more or whatever, and I find I don't annoy anybody with it, so I get no complaints about the volume and all my drumming, thankfully. So here we go, then let's play each one of them, ready? So tom, floor, bass drum, I could probably tune a bit lower to get it a bit beefier, but it's alright, there's nothing much in it, there might be a little pillow in it. If you're in your garage or your bedroom and you're still upsetting your neighbours, maybe really dampen it with a couple of pillows or whatever, or cushions or whatever you fancy, really. So there's your bass, toms. So it's pretty cool. It does feel quite nice to play. I prefer to play this than an acoustic kit with those dampening pads on. I really do. I think they're probably cost more money than a set of acoustic dampening pads. But some shops you can just find sort of loose skins being sold separately, so not in the, if you bought them as a pack they probably cost you quite a bit, but sometimes you find them second hand, just one at a time, because they've been used they're a lot cheaper, but they're still in pretty good condition. I think that's how I got mine. You get them from Graham Russell sells drum heads separately, just very very slightly used ones, and you get them a lot cheaper. So that's the drums. So you basically take all your old, you are under your tension rods, take your hoop or rim off, seat the new mesh head on the drum, put the hoop back on, tension rods, tuning opposites, so the head and the rim is sort of tuned up evenly. Do that for each drum, including the bass drum. So that's the drums. The cymbals, now you could like you could put the dampening pads on the drums, you could put dampening pads on the cymbals, right? Which is all right, but they don't retain their bounce. They sound so muted that they're not a lot of fun. Or, but I mean, you know, if you need to do that, then you need to do that. Or you can buy a set of these things, which are quite costly, so you might just well prefer to put dampening pads on the cymbals. But you can get these things by Zildjian, which are called low volume cymbals. It's a set of them. I've got Hats, Crash Ride. You can get a bigger, I think it's probably just a Ride, a 20. This is a Crash Ride at 18. I think this is a 16 Crash. I think these are just 14 Hats probably, I think they are. And they feel pretty real to play, and I actually really enjoy playing these. So here comes a bit of the cymbals ready. Let's roll the strolls. So, it's alright, isn't it? Hair's on. Sounds pretty good. I think all these cymbals are about 50% of the actual volume of real cymbals. Everything's got a bed on it, I should have said that. It feels quite real to play. There's the ride bell. So yeah, choking away. Sound a lot quieter, cymbals included. I think that's about it. Hopefully that's helpful. Thanks. Bye.